اللهم صل على محمد على سيدنا محمد في الأولين، وصل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين، وصل على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. ما شاء الله، لا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. من الأربعين ولا الاعتكاف، نوين الخلوة، نوين العزلة، نوين الرياضة، نوين السلوك، نوين الصيام لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد، نوين الختم، نوين الذكر، نوين المولد على نية القبول. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. Our way, طريقتنا الصحبة والخير في الجمعية. This is a gathering of dhikrullah. We are coming to sit and remember our Lord on Friday night under the guidance of our teacher in the Naqshbandi Tariqa, Mawlan Shaykh Muhammad Nazim Adi al-Haqqani, Sayyid Shaykh Muhammad Adi al-Rabbani. Those are our teachers. So we start, we are sitting here with their permission and with their support we're asking for. Because awliyaullah, as we believe that they are connected to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We, as Zaman people, we are disconnected, even from our minds, not just from spiritual realities, but we can't even focus for 5 seconds, our mind jumping. We stand in prayer, Allahu Akbar. Then the mind goes. For young people, what am I going to watch next? What's playing tonight? What movie? What video game? For adults, hey, business is bad. How am I going to do this? What's happening? And like this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لا ينظر إلى أجسامكم إن الله لا ينظر إلى أجسامكم وصوركم ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم. Allah is only interested in our hearts. What's in here? When I stand to pray and say Allahu Akbar, what's in here? Dunya, hawa, fears. What am I worshipping? What am I standing and praying to? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to teach us how we empty, tazkiyah to nafs. Tazkiyah is to purify. Whatever in here that's not supposed to be in here, you take it out through tazkiyah. So when you go to the mashayikh, they give you wird. They say, make rabita with us. Be in connection. And recite your awrad, do your adhkar. But not as some foolish people today. They think they join Sufism, they don't have to pray. No. First things first, al-fara'id. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it obligatory for you, you have to do. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you to stay away from, nahak, nawahi, manhiyat, you have to stay away. Then you can do your wird. Don't do awrad if you're not praying. If you have 5 minutes to make your wird, stand up and do your prayer. If you don't have, you go with the fara'id first. Then you add on top of that. Then you have the foundation. Why? Because now you are obedient servant. You have Allah's ordered you to pray, you prayed. Allah's ordered you to fast, you fasted. Allah's ordered you not to cheat, you're not cheating. Allah's ordered you stay away from these things that Allah ordered you. Then you can be in tariqah. You can say now, my Shaykh, what wird I need to do extra? What activities can I do now on top of that? But before that, what tariqah? You're not even following Sharia, what tariqah? You cannot be in tariqah. This is the end of times. And I know I've been talking about very hard in previous sahabas, talking about the Antichrist and some heavy topics. So today I wanted to speak about something, Babur Raja, about being hopeful. Ana anda husni dhanni abdi bi, Allah's Prophet's hadith, that I am according to what my servant, Allah saying, hadith Qudsi, I am according to what my servant thinks of me. So if we believe Allah's is a merciful Lord, loving Lord, forgiving Lord, inshallah. This is our hope, not in our actions, not in our deeds, not in our awrad. So I was looking at Imam Nawawi's, and he has a whole chapter about being hopeful in Allah's mercy. عن عبادة بن الصامت رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من شهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله وأن عيسى ابن الله ورسوله وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه والجنة والنار حق أدخله الله الجنة على ما كان من العمل متفق عليه. This is in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, that whoever Allah, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever bear witness لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, Allah سبحانه وتعالى, and that Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is Prophet, and Sayyidina Isa is also his servant and Prophet, and his word he threw to Sayyidina Maryam, and believes in Jannah and Nar, that they're true, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let him enter into his Jannah, regardless of his deeds. And this here is a beautiful hadith عن أبي ذر رضي الله عنه. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول الله عز وجل من جاء بالحسنة فله عشر أمثالها أو أزيد ومن جاء بالسيئة فجزاء سيئة سيئة مثلها أو أغفر ومن تقرب مني شبرا تقربت منه ذراعا ومن تقرب مني ذراعا تقربت منه باعا ومن أتاني يمشي أتيته هرولا ومن لقيني بقراب الأرض خطيئة لا يشرك بي شيئا لقيته بمثلها مغفرة. This is in Sahih Muslim. Why? And there are many hadiths in this bab, but this beautiful hadith, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that Sayyidina Abu Dharr, whoever does one good deed, Allah will give him 10, at least 10 or more. أو أزيد. Up to 700, even Siyam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you're fasting Ramadan, أصومُ لي وأنا أجزي به. It's according to Allah's generosity, even more than 700. ضعف. And then he said, وَمْ جَاءَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ, and whoever does a sin, فَجَزَاءُ سَيِّئَةٍ سَيِّئَةٌ مِثْلَهَا, one bad deed for one for one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't do 10 times for every sayyid. And he may even forgive it, أو أغفر, even might just erase it also, if a person وَمَنْ تَقَرَّبَ مِنِّي شِبْرًا تَقَرَّبْتُ مِنْهُ ذِرَاعًا, and whoever comes to me, shibr is this span, and ذِرَاع is two shibr, it's two of them. So Allah is saying, whoever comes to me close one shibr, I come to him double, closer. وَمَنْ تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ ذِرَاعًا مِنِّي ذِرَاعًا تَقَرَّبْتُ مِنْهُ بَاعًا, and whoever comes to me two, I come to him one ذِرَاع, double also. Hey, this hadith, Sidi, what we want to speak about is the importance of our faith. If, as some empty, square-headed people, as Mawlana Sheikh Nazim used to say about them, you don't believe in ta'wil, in metaphor, that the Quran may use symbolism, how you explain Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala coming close to you to have to believe Allah is, astaghfirullah, a body? If you don't believe in metaphor, in allegory, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not talking physically, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam not talking about the physical, he's talking about Allah is coming to you closer with his mercy, with his forgiveness, not coming to you handspan, like you're sitting, astaghfirullah, across from, and he comes to you to How you understand this? If they say there is no ta'wil, that everything must be taken literally, how you understand this hadith? And then hadith follows. وَمَنْ تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيْهِ وَمَنْ أَتَانِي يَمْشِي أَتَيْتُهُ هَرْوَلًا. And whoever comes to me walking, Allah is saying, I come to him running. Yahoo, what kind of Lord are we worshipping? We still now have to imagine our Lord running. Is a physical being running? No. Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, in their beliefs, لا مثيل له ولا شبيه له. No mind. كل ما يخطر ببالك فالله خلاف ذلك. Everything this mind can imagine, Allah is other than that. You cannot imagine Allah. If you have, He's different from His creation. So we have bodies, Allah does not have a body. Does not have parts. Is not in need of eyes to hear. Is not in need of ears to hear. Is not in need of eyes to see. How you understand these hadiths unless you believe in ta'wil? That Allah here is saying, I come running to you. How I come running to you with my love and mercy if you approach me. With my forgiveness, with my acceptance. وَمَنْ لَقِيَنِي بِقُرَابِ الْأَرْضِ خَطِيئَةً. Whoever comes to me with this earth full of sin, as if he has, the amount of sin he has is fills this whole earth. لَا يُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا. Without believing in me, I have no partners. I am the only Lord for him. لقيته بمثلها مغفرة. Allah is saying, I will meet him, I will welcome him with as much forgiveness, amount of forgiveness. Whoever comes to me with this earth full of sin, without, this is the key, لا يشرك بي شيئا. This is why it's important to have our aqidah, our belief, correct. Because that is what's going to save you. Coming to Allah without any wrong understanding about Him. This is why we're in the end of times now. A person goes to sleep believing, wakes up unbelieving, according to the Hadith of Prophets. Why? Because the wrong ideas are entering their hearts about their Lord. Because you go to sleep having belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has nothing, لا مثيل له, there is nothing like Him. And then some person sends you a video of a Shaykh or this, and then he tells you, no, Allah has hands and Allah has eyes and Allah is in the first heaven. في السماء, as they use the hadith of the Sharia, he stands in the first heaven. And now you, these kids and us, we're imagining a big astaghfirullah person sitting up there. That's our Lord. That's why Prophet ﷺ said this time is dangerous. It's because we have so many devils trying to poison the aqidah of Muslims. Now, may Allah forgive us. So inshallah we will inshallah in this month of Rajab now coming, it's the month of Allah, we are making our intention, Ya Rabbi, your holy month, it's the first of Ashur al-Hurum, Rajab al-Murajab. It's now, I think, February 2nd, 3rd. We're making our intention, Ya Rabbi, we are sinful, weak, with full of wrong. And we want to make this opportunity, this holy month coming, to be your true servants, inshallah. Make us your true servants. Make us real believers with certainty of belief, with 100% correct belief for you. And make us from those who you love, inshallah. Wa min Allahi tawfiq bi hurmati al-habib bi hurmati al-fatiha. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.